Tools like Canva and Adobe Express make it easier than ever to design absolutely anything online. So whether you're a teacher looking to design lesson materials, perhaps you run a local gym and you want to promote an upcoming class, or maybe you're a business running a conference and you need to create a microsite, they can definitely help you do all of those things and more. So let's dive in. I'll show you some of the basics and some of the key differences as well. So here they are side by side. On the left-hand side, I've got Adobe Express. If I scroll down, we can see there's lots of templates for things here. And on the right-hand side is Canva. Similarly, lots of templates to choose from, and you can create just about anything. You can see the options on here for presentations, social media, all the way through to documents, spreadsheets, and websites as well. But let's start by looking at Adobe Express in a bit more detail. One of the key things that makes Adobe Express stand out is that it's integrated into the wider Creative Cloud set of tools. So you could design things in Adobe Express and take them into Photoshop, or vice versa. For this example, we're going to imagine that I'm running a local business that's putting on a conference, and I want to create a flyer to promote it. To get started, I'm actually just going to go to the search box at the top of the screen here and type conference flyer like this. And that's going to show me all of the templates that match. Let's have a look. There's a lot here to choose from. I can scroll through the selection here. I'm going to choose this one here. I like these green colors. I click on it and then choose customize template, and that takes me through to the editor. There's lots of things I can do here. Obviously, I can click and edit the text as I need to, change the formatting and so on, but I'm going to click on the add content button on the left-hand side here and then choose media. Adobe has a huge range of stock assets that are available in Adobe Express, and so I'm going to search for office building here because I want to replace the picture of a person with the building that we'll be using. I can go to photos and click view all, and you can see there's a huge selection here, lots for free. Any with this crown symbol are premium assets. But I'm going to click and drag this one over to the existing picture like this, and you can see it replaces it. So it keeps that black and white filter that was on there as well. Now let's go and see what this would be like in Canva. So in Canva, I can do a similar thing. I can go to the search box at the top here, type conference flyer. And here are all of the different templates that come up here. I'm going to choose this one at the top like so. Again, I click, then choose customize this template, and I can do really similar things. Again, on the left-hand side, there's a panel called elements here. I can search for things like shapes and graphics and stickers. Again, I'm going to search for office building. There's a selection of photos here. I can see all. Again, that crown symbol means it's only available in Canva Pro. I'm going to scroll down and choose this one. And again, I can just click and drag this onto the existing image like this to update it. Back over in Adobe Express, I'm going to click on mortgage conference here and double click to replace this with coding conference like this. And on the left hand side, you can see that I've got all of my text options, so I can easily change the font. Again, Adobe has a huge selection of fonts available through Adobe Fonts, which if you already have access to Creative Cloud, you'll have access to here as well. I can choose this one, for example, change the size and even the layout and so on too. If I go back to Canva, let's try this here. I'm going to double click to edit this text and put coding conference. And you can see in Canva, all of the options to edit the text are actually at the top of the screen to start with. And when I click here, it then opens the font list on the left-hand side. So I could change the font to something like this, maybe. If I want to change the size and the color, we're back at the top of the page here. So whilst they do very similar things, the layout can be a little bit different. Back to Adobe Express then, I can also invite people to collaborate on these designs. I just click the invite button at the top right of the screen, can type in their email address, and it will send them the link. And we can literally be working on this design at the same time. And it's very similar in Canva as well. If I go back over to my design here, I can click on share on the top right of the screen. And again, add people by putting their email address in here. Then we'd be able to collaborate in real time on this design. Now we've looked at flyers and creating printed materials so far, but did you know you can also create websites in both Adobe Express and Canva? So let's take a look at doing that in Adobe Express to start with. So back on the homepage of Adobe Express here, I'm going to scroll down a little bit further, and you can see we've got options for blank canvases. So I'm going to choose web page. There are only a handful of website templates on Adobe Express. I'm going to go to event here, and I want to create a website for this event. I quite like this blue business event template, so I click select. And the website builder in Adobe Express is quite simple, it makes it really easy to use. I can just highlight some text like this and make edits, and I can click on this plus button here to add other blocks if I want to add a button or photos or other things like videos, for example. I can scroll down to see the whole site. And if I want to preview it, I just click the play button at the top of the screen like this. That shows me what this website is going to look like. Personally, for me, I think there's a bit too much space between all of the elements, and it's not really something that you can change in this editor. So I'm going to close this and let's go and take a look at creating an event website in Canva. So again, I'm back in the Canva homepage, but this time I'm going to choose website from the list at the top of the screen here. And Canva, just like with every other type of thing you can create here, also has tons of templates for websites. So I could just search for conference website like so. You can see there's lots here that I can scroll through. I'm going to choose this green one. All I have to do is click and I can actually choose the different sections of the page if I want to as well, but I'm going to choose apply all 5 sections like this. So I can make changes to the titles again, just highlight all of that text and put coding conference, for example. And in Canva, all of the editing tools that you use for a website are exactly the same as the ones that you do for print. So all of those text editing tools are still at the top. But one thing you can do in Canva is integrate with other tools. And I would really like to put a registration form on this website so people can sign up for the event directly on the site. So I'm going to scroll to the bottom here, click add section. And on the left-hand side of the screen, we see we have an option for apps. If I click on there, I can search for apps and I'm going to search for Jotform. You can see that Jotform comes up as an app. And Jotform has thousands of different templates. So I'm going to search for event registration form. This one looks fine. I click use template and it has inserted that form directly onto my Canva design. Now this is already linked to my Jotform account, so I can also go and access forms that I've already created. So for now, I'm actually going to delete this one here because if I go to your forms on the left here, I've created a customized version which matches the color scheme of this website. So I've clicked to insert it, and here we go. It's now embedded on the page like this. And if I want to preview what this website looks like, I go to click preview at the top right of the screen here, and I can scroll through like this. And at the bottom, you can see that the Jotform is embedded on the website and people could fill it out right here to sign up for the site. And I would get all of the responses back in my Jotform account. So there you go. Both Canva and Adobe Express are great design tools in their own right. Both of them allow you to create things all the way from printed flyers through to websites and more. And they're both free to get started as well. Adobe Express benefits from being part of the Creative Cloud Suite. So if you already have access to that, it's likely that you already have premium Adobe Express. So you can access all of those premium assets inside as well. And Canva benefits from really good integrations with third-party tools like Jotform. So you can integrate those forms right inside your website with no extra work. And you don't even need to create the form from scratch because Jotform has thousands of templates. My advice would be to give them both a try and see what works best for you. And you can find the links to do that in the description. If this was helpful, don't forget to subscribe and give us a like. And if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. I'll see you next time.